welcome back to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Everything good?
Pretty good.
Yeah, yeah, things are going pretty well, yeah.
Pretty good.
Oh, I wanted to ask you quickly about this. I heard this story, I don't know if it's true or not, and if it's not true, we can cut it out of the show.
Okay.
But did you audition for Wicked?
I did. And I sure did.
You did?
Yeah. Yes. Wicked is like one of my favorite musicals. I was there the night it reopened after the pandemic. Like, I love Wicked.
Yeah.
And
me too.
They called me and asked if I would want to audition for Elphaba, which is the Green Witch.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Very exciting. But I was like, really? Do I have to sing the like,
like, yeah, oh yeah, they are.
Like, that's like a like
yeah, the commercial, yes, of course.
I'd say that's the part. It's like the best, you know, I'm sure everyone here has seen Wicked. It's like the best, it's end of act one
it's
of all
powerful.
Time. She flies and she goes,
yeah.
And so I was like, yeah, oh my God, yes, of course. And well, they need the like, and they were like, yeah, let's check. So they actually will need the, and I was like, okay.
Okay, pressure's
got
on.
Got it. So I had 2 weeks, and this was also my first in-person audition since COVID. So, like, I hadn't been in a room with people. Anyway.
A little rusty.
A little shaky.
Yeah.
Not great for singing. Not great for high notes.
No.
And I just found myself, like, walking around my apartment. It was like the telltale heart. Like, all I could hear was, like, And anytime I would talk to someone, I would, like, be, like, 500 miles away, just, like, quietly thinking of, like, like, over and over and over.
Like, I gotta nail it.
And then the big day comes, and they're like, you know, oh, they're, and they're so nice, and they're lovely, and they're like, come on in, oh my gosh, so nice to meet you, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, it's so nice to meet you, too.
Your actual voice.
Yeah, and you can feel, like, I can just feel myself being like, uh-huh, and so what do you want to begin with? And we start singing through the songs, and I'm like doing it. Like, we're singing the songs, we're like getting through. We're hitting When I Meet the Wizard, we're hitting Not That Girl, like all these things. And
Kristen,
then
great.
They were like, are you ready for the big boy? And I was like, yeah, I'm ready. Yeah, let's do it. I can do this. And they start the music, and this like calmness washes over me. And I'm like, oh, this is gonna be like a 90s movie. Like, it's gonna be slow-mo, like League of Their Own. Like, I'm actually gonna be able to do it.
Wow.
Like, I think I'm gonna do it. I think I'm gonna hit this crazy note that I've been obsessing over. And I like opened my mouth wide, I took a deep breath, and the sound that escaped me is something I will hear on my deathbed. Like, I will never not hear what I did in that room.
Really?
It was disgusting. It was like...
No.
No, it was. It was like when you hear coyotes attack as a group. Like, it was horrible. It was like there was an injury. It sounded terrible. And then the worst part is that there was like this silence that followed.
Oh my God.
And especially like, oh my God, blah, blah, blah. Like, and I knew what I'd done, and they knew what I'd done, and they had these like sort of like paint plastered smiles, and they were so nice, and they were like, Kristen, thank you so much. And I was like, oh no. Yeah, like, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That being said, I mean, I cannot. But I am so excited for that movie, and specifically Cynthia Erivo
got cast.
Is who should be singing that? Like,
Cynthia Erivo is not like, yeah, it's like,
oh my God, she, I saw her.
Oh, I played the guitar to get the audition. Yeah, we gave it to Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah.
It's like, oh my God.
She, like, I saw her in The Color Purple, and when she sings, like, you know, it's like a spirit. I leapt to my feet every time. I cannot wait to hear.
But you are phenomenal too. I want to hear you sing.
You
should do a musical.
No, but
please, you're great. You know you are.
I want to do.
All right,
you should
do a musical.
I'm dying to do a musical. I don't think that, like, my voice necessarily fits the, like...
For that one, yeah.
Like, that, you know, that's... I wish it did.
I want to talk about The Penguin.
Sure, okay.
It's on HBO. This is... Everyone's buzzing about this, talking about this. You debuted this at Comic-Con in San Diego this summer.
Yeah.
What was that like?
Oh, my gosh. I mean, it was outrageous. It was like getting hit by a Mack truck in the best way. I mean, I'm such a huge Batman fan.
Yeah.
And I've been, like, wanting to play a Batman villain my entire life, and I grew up on these movies, and it's like wildly profound and moving to me. And so to be in
this
a
is
room,
like, how many people are we talking?
6,000.
6,000 people that love
people
Batman.
That love Batman.
Oh yeah, don't mess with my Batman.
Yeah, and we show them this trailer that they'd showed me before, which is like it was like they love dropping trailers. Yep. Like, well, this is a new trailer. But yep. It shows my character in Arkham, which was like, you know, for someone who loves Batman, when they put that uniform on me, I was like, oh my God, it's canon. Like, you know, so excited. So to get to watch 6,000 people, to get to watch that with 6,000 people was like, my blood was seltzer. I was like, floating.
Your blood was seltzer.
My blood was seltzer.
That's really
and
good.
Then I like had to sleep for 3 days afterward because it was like the most fabulous
exciting.
Adrenaline
it
rush.
Crushed.
Oh, yeah.
I have to say that when Colin Farrell did the Penguin and the Batman, it was unbelievable. I didn't know it was him.
It's crazy.
I finished the movie.
It's outrageous.
Normally, if I see it, I can kind of see it. I go, that person's going like, they're wearing a rubber mask, and you go, yeah, I get it.
Totally.
I did not understand.
No,
I go, what do you mean he was in that movie?
Yeah, and up close, you know, it's so real. It moves.
This is Colin Farrell, one of my favorite actors. He's unbelievable,
God, extraordinary.
Right? Yeah, and then
one
this
of our
is
best.
This is him as Oz Cobb as the Penguin.
There he is. There's my guy.
No, it's unbelievable.
Yeah,
look at
it's
this.
Unbelievable, and such a testament to Mike Marino who did that makeup.
What's it like talking to this guy and then this guy?
Well. It's interesting because I'd only met Colin, this Colin.
Yeah.
The one.
Yeah.
A few times in person, and we shot together for 8 months, and I only knew Oz. And it's so strange because I associate, I know those eyes and that voice so well from just being like, how was your weekend? You know, whatever.
Yeah.
And so when I see him outside of that, it's like very jarring because Oz is more of a real person who I've spent more time with than Colin.
That's
and
odd.
It feels like someone has like Freaky Friday'd or body swapped. It's like something's like wrong. It feels like when you've been like riding a bicycle all day and then like you get off the bicycle and you're like, whoa.
Yeah.
Like I saw him a couple times outside of makeup and it was like a cat with socks on. I didn't love it. Because <You know? laughs> it's so jarring.
But when you do these, you're not allowed to tell anyone anything. It's all secretive.
Yes.
I mean, do you, are you good at that or do you?
I mean, no, I mean, I probably, I mean, I like.
Well, you can't even say. Can you say who?
I mean, I like tell my friends.
You do.
I know. Well, you got.
Good for you. Good. I'm glad someone admitted.
Finally, they admitted.
Yeah, you tell your friends.
Like tell your friends. I mean, I'm like, don't tell anyone.
Yeah, and they don't. They didn't.
You know, and they didn't. Yeah.
Yeah, like good friends.
Yeah.
What can we say about this without giving too much away?
Well.
We're all your friends.
Yeah, you're all my friends, right? I would say that. So I play Sofia Falcone and. Oz and I battle it out for who's going to run Gotham. We're like each other's villains. And it sort of follows us as we battle for control of the city.
How fun.
I know.
How fun
yeah.
it is.
I know, it's
I want
fun.
To show a clip. Here's Kristen Milioti in The Penguin. Take a look.
You think you know what's best for me? You think you know what I need? How are you any different than those pricks in there? Very, very convenient. All of a sudden, you're on my side. Well, you look at that, right? My little helper.
All right.
Desperate. You are scrambling for whatever dignity you have left, and you're hoping I will save you. Not gonna happen. I don't know you thing.
No, you're right, you don't. I owe you.
Whoa, come on! Kristen Milioti! The Penguin premieres September 19th on HBO and Max. We'll be right back with a performance from Talib Kweli and Jay Rawls. Stick around, everybody.